Hello everybody, Christian from Treasure Town here, and today we're going to be speaking about the 1889 Morgan Silver Dollar. Definitely a lot to learn here, whether it's the VAMs that are going to make these coins worth significantly more than their regular counterparts without them. These are things where if you look closely, you might be able to find them. Could be on already graded coins. A lot of people miss them. There's also some mint errors to talk about, the history behind the proofs, deep mirror proof-like coins. I will also go over the values at different conditions, as well as for all these different attributes that might be going on, plus the story of how the 1889 P Morgan dollar specifically came to be what it is today. So let's get right into the presentation. So let's start talking about this 1887 Morgan dollar, the history of the general Morgan dollar. This was after the trade dollar. There was not yet free silver. There was a movement to have a ton of silver coined to sort of enforce a bimetallic standard that would favor some of the farmers and some of the wage earners that would benefit from a little bit of inflation, because there was a sustained deflation since the Civil War that was really hurting wage earners and people who really didn't have quite as good financial prospects. So this act overrides the veto from super support in Congress of Rutherford B. Hayes, and purchases $2 to $4 million worth of silver that would just be coined into $1 coins. And these were the designs that were chosen. And that act led to really high mintages, especially in the late 1880s at the Philadelphia Mints. So this is part of that, that it would increase a bit more until a economic panic in 1893. People realized that they needed to scale that back. So it was, there would be a little bit more, and eventually it would run out in 1904. The Pittman Act a few years later after World War I would bring it back. Though a fair amount of these were likely melted during that, and they're still easily found in really nice condition. So if you want a coin for your typeset, this could be a good example, just because they're not going to be super expensive. If you're just looking for, you know, an example of a really good looking Morgan dollar. Now, they're not as rare. They were released in 1,000 coin bags, at which they were stored in through the early 1960s up until about 1964. And people were getting these 1,000 coin bags and sometimes not even really trading them. Now, that was more of a problem with the 1888, and the strike quality was not great, nor was it pretty bad. So it was just sort of in the middle. But as you can see, $300 for Mint State 66, which is just a really, really nice looking coin, is quite cheap compared to a lot of other dates. And Mint State 63, 64, still pretty low values, only 190 for Mint State 65. And there's 20,290,000 of these produced. Now, I should mention that the grade where it really gets valuable is probably Mint State 67, with a big jump to 7 plus and 8. And there is the Donkey Tail VAM. There's a few VAMs, but you should look for these because sometimes people don't realize that they have them. One with a Mint State 63 grade sold for $10,000, and that's the only sale I could find. So this is a pretty serious one. And I'm only looking at VAMs in the top 100, Hot 50, or Hit List 40. This one has a clashed E from the Liberty in the Morgan cap. On the other side, when the dies would come together without a coin in between and would imprint on the other one. I'm not going to focus as much on the values. These are a little more muted, but it's nice if you can see the E. We have a double date here. We're in the top loop of the second 8. You can see a little bit of a chip. Now, as you can see, the values really don't get too much more expensive, but it is considered one of the VAMs of interest. And then there's this doubled eye variety where it's like a small spread, the alligator eye on the outside of Morgan's eye on the front of the coin. There's also a few errors, though they're not too crazy. The planchet was, something came between the planchet and the obverse die when it struck here and led to this $170 Mint State 63 coin. There's also a partial collar where it wasn't fully retained by the collars that are around the coin to ensure good striking. So there's some rim issues, like the rim looks like it's somewhat off. I think that you can see that best on the bottom. You can't always see it head on. This sold for $320 in Mint State 63. The proofs, there were 710 minted. not crazy valuable in proof 63 and 65, but still, I mean, a few thousand dollars, jumps in proof 67 to 15,000. This is really how collectors were getting their coins. The proof mintages were really small. Maybe they were paying 10 cents over the dollar to purchase these, but that's often why a mint state 68 is so expensive, because nobody really cared about really nice looking examples at the time that they were being produced. And then the proof like versus deep mirror proof like. Here are some of the values. It's pretty attainable. These, you know, if it's fresh dyes, they're going to produce deep mirror. As they strike more, they go to just regular proof likes. And the values, yeah, I mean, maybe slightly more than double for the proof like, and probably triple or four times the normal for the deep mirror proof like. But that's what we've got here today. Look for these VAMs, and yeah, good luck finding them. Thanks for watching the video. I'd encourage you to like the video, comment, and make sure to subscribe to my channel. And I also have Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and some other social media platforms. You can also go to my main channel website, treasuretownyt.com, to learn more about the channel and sort of stay in contact. I also will eventually host all of these videos on coinsmetalscards.com, which will be both news, marketplace, and coin information. I do have the goal of eventually getting pretty much every U.S. coin, date, mint mark, denomination on the channel with a similar video to the one that you just watched, and that will likely all be hosted there. And then I also have treasuretowncoins.com, which is sort of my coin dealing wing, coin dealing only entity that is a little bit less focused on content production. So thank you so much, and I'll look forward to seeing you on some of my other videos. I also have videos that are not just the date mint mark denomination recap in this format, so you can check some of those out, and I'll have fun seeing you there.